Welcome to this tutorial series for ARP from Midicake. In this video, I'll highlight each of ARP's features and how to navigate its controls. The interface is divided into six areas: note and chord buttons, global control buttons, arpeggiator selection buttons, the LCD display to provide visual feedback, four macro controls, and USB and MIDI connections on the back. Press a chord button to cue up the associated chord type, then press a note to play that chord. An external MIDI controller can also be used to play the arpeggiator. The play button will start the arpeggiators, and stop will end the sequence. Pause will hold notes, and pressing stop twice will kill all playing notes. The speed of the arpeggiators can be altered using the tempo knob. This is disabled if ARP detects an external MIDI clock. The up and down buttons control the global octave for all four arpeggiators. The four arpeggiators each have a mute button to silence them. The follow buttons allow you to play each arpeggiator on a different bar, enabling interesting sequencing of melodies. ARP is not limited to the default chords. Holding a chord button lets you choose an alternative scale. Or create your own by toggling the note buttons. You can quickly reset this if you need to. Basic sequencing of chords can be achieved by pressing the program button. Press the note buttons in sequence to create a chain of chords. So far, we've been using ARP in play mode. Use the set button to switch to set mode. The parameters that control an individual arpeggiator's sequence are highlighted in blue and are labelled below each button. Select the individual arpeggiators using the ARP Select buttons. The note buttons are home to parameters that control the basic shape of a sequence. The chord buttons house parameters that change the behaviour of the sequence, including modes, patterns, effects, modulations, and MIDI output options. You can also access the global settings using the menu button. Some parameters have multiple options. Repeatedly press the button to access them. You can still play ARP in set mode, and parameter changes will be applied in real time and saved automatically. There's much more on parameters later in this series. Pressing the set button again will return to play mode. The four arpeggiator sequences are saved in a patch. ARP can store 16 banks of 12 patches. You can load patches by pressing the load button, then using up-down to select the bank and pressing one of the numbered note buttons to apply that patch. This can be done while ARP is playing and will change on the bar. You can copy patches in the same way using the copy button, which can be used to create variations that can be played back during a performance. The macro knobs can be assigned to individual parameters and provide a quick way to change those parameters during a performance. It's as easy as holding the macro button, selecting the ARP and parameter. All of ARP's parameters can also be linked to an external MIDI CC controller by holding the CC Learn button and selecting the parameter to control. On the back, ARP has MIDI over USB, USB MIDI host, and MIDI DIN ports. It supports I/O and MIDI through on all three connection methods simultaneously. That's it for this video. In the next one, we'll go into more detail on playing and editing chords. Please hit like if you found this video helpful, and perhaps subscribe if you haven't already. If you have any views or questions, feel free to comment below or message us via midicake.com. Cheers, see you in the next one.